फोर्स पॉलीगॉन मेथड. दिस मेथड इज ऑल्सो नोन एज लॉ ऑफ पॉलीगॉन ऑफ फोर्सेस. And it is nothing but one type of extension of triangle law of forces, because a triangle law of forces is generally used for two number of forces, but here the polygon law of forces that is used for a number of forces to resolve the resultant of that particular given forces. Now if we look at to the statement of that, so it is similar to that, the law of polygon of forces. So if a number of forces acting simultaneously on a particle, and that is represented in magnitude and direction by the sides of a polygon taken in order, then a resultant of all these forces may be represented in magnitude and direction by the closing side of the polygon taken in opposite order. Now how to take it, that we see in this particular system of forces. So if we have a number of forces, so here force P1 that is acting in this direction, another force if we take that is acting in this particular direction, that is force P2, and another force that is force P3 that is acting in this particular direction. Now here the forces are more than two, so this is useful when we have this type of condition, and this all forces are acting at point O. Now the solution of this system that is given by graphical method, so this force polygon method is generally known as a one type of graphical method. So considering the area with the Bohr's notation that we represent in form of A, B and the C, so here force P1, P2 and P3 are acting on particle O, then if we make a force polygon which define a different sides in terms of the forces, so let me try to draw that polygon here. So we just for a simplicity fix the base of that polygon. Now as a starting point we consider the first force, that is our force P1, with respect to the maintaining direction of that P1 force that we just draw here, and the magnitude that is considered with the proper scale. After that we have to take a second force, that is force P2, again maintaining a magnitude with respect to the scale and a direction of that P2 force. So here this is a P2 force, and the third force that is a P3 force, again that is with its proper direction and the magnitude depending on the given scale. This is a P3 force. Now here we have a such type of polygon, and that polygon is joined by the fourth side, that is nothing but a resultant of that given three number of forces. So we write down A to B, so that represents a P1 force side, B to C, P2 force side, and C to D, that is the final closing of the polygon. Now if you measure this side of the polygon, that is nothing but a magnitude of resultant according to the chosen scale. And here this is a theta that represents the direction of the resultant according to the given axis. Now in this force polygon is said to be closed polygon if the polygon formed by the forces results into a closed figure. Closed figure, that means if this point that reaches up to this point, then this figure is known as a closed polygon. But if resultant is not zero, okay, now here there is a some value of resultant, right, and this is known as a not, or we can say the non-closed polygon. But if it is in form of the closed polygon, so at that time the value of resultant would be zero, so that is known as a closed polygon. So here we can write down this is a open polygon. So this is all about force polygon method.